Get ready to match the stars. Bob Barker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Paddy Duke Astin, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers!
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us. Just want to remind you of the captains and the kings and the price is right.
The price is right.
The price, I forgot to say that, so I'll say
and
that
fire.
Right. And fire.
Fire.
What is that?
I'm a doctor in fire.
Really?
It's a disaster.
Take my pulse. Oh, really? Doctor, I'm feeling better already. Hello there.
Hi.
Are you ready? We're in the middle of round two. When you get your question, one to tie, two to win. You ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, she's got her fingers crossed, and we'll do that right after we do this, especially for you. Here we go. Ding! Okay, Johnny, one to tie, two to win. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Bob said, to be honest with you, I didn't like either candidate who was running for office. So, all I did was go into the voting booth and blank. All right. Did you hear that, Johnny? As soon as we get those two lights going there, Charles and Brett's. Well, Brett's is on now. Charles is finished. Here we go, Johnny. Bob said, to be honest with you, I didn't like either candidate who was running for office. So all I did was go into the voting booth and blank.
Tinkle.
Really?
She has been watching this show. This
democracy gets no respect.
I turned it on last week and I learned the key words. Boobs, tinkles,
party. Stop
that. And here was my opportunity and I blew it. I said
really?
That he went into the... took a nap.
Took a little nap.
Took a nap. Just a moment. One more, please.
Yes, one
May
more.
I just say that I liked the audience yesterday much better than this
yes, one. Yes, of course. They were kinder to you, weren't they? Now, here we go, Brett.
I say if you gotta go, you gotta go. Tinkle.
Tinkle again.
Tie score.
One more wet ballot wins the game for her.
I said I made a dirty phone call. I didn't like the image of tinkling.
All right. Tie score, 1-1. To be honest with you, I didn't like either candidate who was running for office, so all I did was go into the voting booth and...
change my clothes.
Change my clothes. Very interesting. Came out a Republican. What do you say?
I never thought of ringing a bell at all, darling. That was absolutely marvelous. But I did think of tinkling.
She's got another shot at Richard. Listen, this is a very close game because her answer was cuss, so the final score really was 2-1. She got 2 there, you got 1. You're a very good game player, and we're delighted
Enjoyed
to
it.
Meet you.
Thank you.
A lot of gifts will be coming.
Thank
to
you
here.
Very much.
Goodbye.
Bye.
There it is. Johnny Beetleman. Shall we go?
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience, my dear, and we got their best response to this. Battle of Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often gets you $500 if you match it. You match the middle one, you get $250. Bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard?
The James Coco story, Battle of the Bulbs.
Yeah! Battle of the Bulbs? He means every word of it, James.
Fanny.
The Brett Summers Klugman story, The Battle of the Sexes.
Okay.
Charles.
And Charles.
I don't think we should ever forget. The battle of Gettysburg.
That's terrible.
Now, wait a minute. You can't boo the Battle of Gettysburg. I won't allow that. Just stop that.
The musical 1776.
They got Gettysburg, the Bulge, and the Sexes. Do you want one of those? Maybe you got a better answer.
No, I learned my lesson. I'm going with Richard, Battle of the Bulge.
Battle of the Bulge. Well, Johnny, I hate to tell you about this. He's not wrong very often, but this time he's wrong.
Oh, am I? I say that.
I don't have no idea. I don't see these things before they happen. Charles, you're standing up. You're ready for your answer. You think it's going to be right up here. All right. Let's reveal the Battle of Gettysburg so Charles can sit down. Go, Earl. Waterloo.
I could make a motion with my hand, but I'm saluting.
All right.
Waterloo.
Here we go. We're looking for the Battle of the Bulge. Maybe we see the $250 number. Well, remember, what did I tell you?
He's not wrong.
I still have
I'm gonna
faith.
Kiss him.
You still think you're going to kiss him? All right. She's looking for the Battle of the Bulge so she can give a kiss to Richard. May we see it, please? Congratulations. Now, you picked up another $500. You got $950. $950 is what you got, but right now you're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $5,000. Whom do you call on for an assist here?
Richard.
Okay. All right, get your ESP flowing over to Richard, and let's see how you do with it now. $5,000 is the net worth of this one. Blank building. Blank building. B-U-I-L-D-I-N-G. Blank building. Johnny, we ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his and collect the $5,000. Blank building.
I can't think of anything but Empire State.
The audience thinks you've chosen the correct one. I would say that's about the most famous building in the world, isn't it? I suppose there are other answers to this, but if I were playing, I'd do the same thing. We'll find out now if Richard thought of the same thing. May we see it, please?
That's a double-worded answer, and I was just thinking of the...
One word.
Well...
No, two.
Two Empire. Words! Messages just for you. Hello. Now let's all welcome Diane Kelber. Now, Diane, before we ask you where you're from and all that, we'd like to focus on Charles Nelson Reilly there for a moment. And just find out, what are you doing, Charles?
Well, I didn't know it was noticeable.
What?
I'm just reading a very moving letter from a five-year-old child to the editor in the paper.
What's it saying?
It says, "Dear editor, why has my mommy and daddy and all of America forgotten the Battle of Gettysburg?" What a moving letter.
Okay, thanks, Charles.
I never got a bicentennial minute. This was it.
I didn't either. Okay, Diane, please tell us where you're from.
I'm from Upland, California.
Yep.
And I work for a local government firm where I'm an analyst.
Yep.
And I'm married and I have one child.
Well, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Are you ready to play?
I sure am.
Good, here we go. Boing. A or B, Diane?
B, please.
B it is for Diane. B for Diane. Right. Chief Prancing Deer is a very strange Indian. I'm going to tell you how strange he is. Just shut up and be patient. Before he scalps you, he blanks your hair.
Wow.
Chief Prancing Deer is a very strange Indian. Before he scalps you, he blanks your hair. Okay. Here we go. Diane Kelber. Chief Prancing Deer is a very strange Indian. Before he scalps you, he blanks your hair.
He washes it.
He washes your hair? I'm going to scalp you.
Well, this poor child, I grew up on an Indian reservation in South Dakota.
That's right, you did.
And the Indians, they were clean, but even more interested, they were more interested, rather than being clean, they were more interested in their appearance. They would curl the hair.
Oh! Curl first and scalp later. We got the message.
You obviously have a group of pale faces.
Right.
Yes. Don't boo the Indians. They'll go on the warpath.
That's right.
Right.
Isn't that cute?
Oh, that
Somebody
is.
Somebody sent that to
oh,
me.
Oh, look
it's
at that.
It's me.
And that looks like you, too.
And is that terrific?
Yeah, that's very well done.
And she has a whole wardrobe.
Oh.
A little girl called, I wish she could write better, Sharon Carlton.
I mean, I love it. Did you notice the address? Gettysburg, Pennsylvania.
Yes, yes.
Well, Wash was really? A nice answer. Just keep crying. But I said sets or styles.
Sets or styles does not match wash, Charles.
It don't?
No, it don't.
Oh, okay.
I chose teases.
Teases!
Cute.
Oh, I've got my answer. What do you say, Patty?
Before you do that, you gotta wash your hair.
Wash! What does this Indian do, Richard?
Well, in the salon business, we say shampoos.
Shampoos. Right? Yes.
Shampoo.
Shampoo, that's true for her.
The bottom line.
Very good for the bottom line.
Where are the champs?
What was your answer?
Blow dry.
Oh,
you
blow
know,
dry.
And sets and all that. Okay, here we go. Ready, John? Johnny? Now. Oh. Hey, you know what?
What?
The warden's son said, he says, my father, the warden, is mean.
How mean is he?
You've improved quite a bit, you know that? Yeah. I tell you how mean my father is. Yesterday, just to make an example, he took my teddy bear and blanked him. That's how mean my father, the warden, is. Oh, she does look better, I must say.
Yes, she does.
It really does. It's a green
it's
one,
all
whatever
that
she's
bloody
doing.
Sleep I've been yeah. getting.
Okay, here we go. Ready, Charles? Wait, he's still writing.
Oh!
Okay, here we go. The warden's son said, he says, my father, the warden, is mean. Now, yesterday, just to make an example, he took my teddy bear and he blanked him.
Executed.
Electrocuted?
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute, Johnny.
Well, that's the best of both worlds.
That's right. She said electrocuted. And we'll leave it up to the judge to figure out what is going to match and what is electrocuted. Boy, she's covering all bases here. What do you say?
Well, something so violent, you see.
Yes.
And all this talk about the family hour and television. And electrocuted did occur to me, but I went the other way and spanked.
Spanked.
Just a moment. I will be on television when these people who say electrocuted are no more.
Right.
You say, with my spanks.
Thank you for playing the wheel game. Yeah.
I didn't mind the answer. The answer wasn't too bad. It's just the explanation was boring.
Well. Oh, oh,
what do you say?
I said it took a little minute for me to get it, but I finally made it.
Electrocuted? Electrocuted. What do you say, Charles?
Could I put the blue dress on the doll now, Annie Brett?
Yeah. Electrocute.
Okay. How did you guess him? He meant just to make an example, he took my teddy bear and he blanked him.
Electrocuted.
Electrocuted.
There you go. You, sir. Electrocuted.
Electrocuted. Now what? Here we go. Shazam.
Exactly. I don't believe it.
Exactly.
That's either Kleenex
wait
or
minute.
Electrocuted.
Electrocuted.
Now, wait a minute.
That is an exact match.
He says electrocuted.
Fantastic.
Electrocuted. You are cute. I think we ought to give this to her as a souvenir card for an exact
So there we are at the end of round one. Score is 5-3. Got a couple of pretty good game players here. Let's see how it ends after this. All right, here we go. Final round. And now,
oh,
Diane,
devil.
You may have A or B.
B again, please.
B again?
B
no.
Again. We don't play.
The lower tier, the superior bunch, does not play. This is only for the dummies up on top there. I'm only kidding there. Oh, sorry, I'm always just a little touch of humor there.
Oh, okay.
Dumb Dora, so dumb.
How dumb is she?
Dumb Dora, so dumb, she thinks toothpaste is for people with blank teeth. She thinks toothpaste is for people with blank teeth.
See this? Yeah. What this means?
Yeah, that means you're smart.
Right.
You understand.
Right.
You understand. Okay. Diane Kelper. Diane, Dumb Dora is so dumb, she thinks toothpaste is for people with blank teeth.
False teeth.
I guess I was wrong.
Oh,
bless
terrific.
You. Bless you, Tiny Tim.
I thought I was on the verge of a great comeback.
Yeah.
But I have loose teeth.
I think that's the right answer.
You do?
Yeah. I would have said loose teeth if I were playing, because I accented toothpaste, you see,
we're
Diane.
Have to move him down here.
And that's why he said loose. He
that's
got
right.
The point there. What do you say?
It's the first applause I've heard today.
You know, when I went like that,
yeah.
I thought I had it. I said loose, too. I'm
yeah.
Sorry.
Now, that means Johnny Gilman wins today. There you go. Congratulations one more time, Johnny. You're now past $6,000. We're going to say goodbye to Diane. Some many lovely gifts will be coming your way. It was a pleasure meeting Diane Kelper, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. Well, here you are. You're an old hand at this, aren't you?
Yeah, I don't know by now.
Listen, you're over 6,000. Now let's see how you do with this one. We polled a recent studio audience, Johnny. We got their best response to this. Dennis Blank. Remember, it's $500 for the most frequently given answer. $250 if you match the second most popular one, and $100 for the third. And let's see what kind of help you'll get from our celebrities here.
Charles.
What do you say, Charles?
Notice the hush I command from an audience. It's very moving. Oh, don't turn on me. Dennis the Menace.
Okay.
Richard.
Richard, what is yours?
Well, a fellow MC who's a nice man, Dennis James.
Dennis James.
Patty.
Patty.
Dennis Day.
Dennis Day. All right. You may have Dennis Day, Dennis the Menace, or Dennis James.
Dennis the Menace.
Dennis the Menace. Well, let's see if we got a comic strip character up there anywhere. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Dennis Weaver. That's a comic strip character. No, we want Dennis the Menace. May we see the $250 number? Dennis Day. That was Patty's answer. Last chance for Dennis the Menace. Here we go. Yeah. Now, Johnny, you got $6,550. And you're going to play, remember, for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And you've got to match one celebrity exactly in order to collect.
I'm on my vibes with Richard.
Okay, Richard.
Of course, I gave her Dennis James.
Yeah, naturally. She gave him back. Ready. Here we go. You got your ESP? You think the vibes are really going? Okay. She's vibing. Fan blank. That's F-A-N blank. Fan blank. Well, he didn't take any time at all to make up his mind on that one. What do you say to that to match him? Fan blank.
Dancer.
Fan dancer. You're older than you look, my dear, if you remember Sally Ram, the fan dancer. And I guess I must be, too. What do you say to that, Richard?
Well, there were several. I'd never thought of that one, Don. Fan club or fan mail?
Fan club or fan mail. They were good. Now, Johnny, you're up to $6,550, and you're going to meet another player later after we do a little business with America. Hello, and goodbye. You were splendid. Join us next time on Nashville 76.
Ready to match the stars, Bob Barker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Paddy Duke Astin, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76,
Johnny Olson, thank you for joining us. Just want to remind you of the captains and the kings and the price is right.
The price is right.
The price, I forgot to say that, so I'll say
and
that
fire.
Right. And fire.
And fire.
What is that?
I'm a doctor in fire.
Really?
It's a disaster.
Take my pulse. Oh, really? Doctor, I'm feeling better already. Hello there.
Hi.
Are you ready? We're in the middle of round two. When you get your question, one to tie, two to win. You ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, she's got her fingers crossed, and we'll do that right after we do this, especially for you. Here we go. Ding! Okay, Johnny, one to tie, two to win. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Bob said, to be honest with you, I didn't like either candidate who was running for office. So, all I did was go into the voting booth and blank. Did you hear that, Johnny? As soon as we get those two lights going there, Charles and Brett's. Well, Brett's is on now. Charles is finished. Here we go, Johnny. Bob said, to be honest with you, I didn't like either candidate who was running for office. So all I did was go into the voting. We polled a recent studio audience, my dear, and we got their best response to this. Battle of Lane. Now, the answer they gave most often gets you $500 if you match it. You match the middle one, you get $250. Bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard?
The James Coco story, Battle of the Bulbs.
Yeah! Battle of the Bulbs? He means every word of it, James.
Fanny.
The Brett Summers Klugman story, The Battle of the Sexes.
Okay.
Charles.
And Charles.
I don't think we should ever forget. The Battle of Gettysburg.
That's terrible.
Now, wait a minute. You can't boo the Battle of Gettysburg. I won't allow
that's
that. Just stop that.
The musical 1776.
They got Gettysburg, the Bulge, and the Sexes. Do you want one of those? Maybe you got a better answer.
No, I learned my lesson. I'm going with Richard, Battle of the Bulge.
Battle of the Bulge. Well, Johnny, I hate to tell you about this. He's not wrong very often, but this time he's wrong.
Oh, am I? I say that.
I don't have no idea. I don't see these things before they happen. Charles, you're standing up. You're ready for your answer. You think it's going to be right up here. All right. Let's reveal the Battle of Gettysburg so Charles can sit down. Go, Earl. Waterloo.
I could make a motion with my hand, but I'm saluting.
All right.
Oh, Waterloo.
Here we go. We're looking for the Battle of the Bulge. Maybe we see the $250 number.
Oh, nobody.
Well,
Remember, what did I tell you?
He's not wrong.
I still have
faith.
I'm
going to kiss him.
You still think you're going to kiss him? All right. She's looking for the Battle of the Bulbs so she can give a kiss to Richard. May we see it, please. Congratulations. Now, you picked up another $500.
Yeah.
You got $950. But the most $950 is what you got, but right now you're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $5,000. Whom do you call on for an assist here?
Richard.
Okay. All right, get your ESP flowing over to Richard, and let's see how you do with it now. $5,000 is the net worth of this one. Blank building. Blank building. B-U-I-L-D-I-N-G. Blank building. Johnny, we ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his and collect the $5,000. Blank building.
I can't think of anything but Empire State.
The audience thinks you've chosen the correct one. I would say that's about the most famous building in the world, isn't it? I suppose there are other answers to this, but if I were playing, I'd do the same thing. We'll find out now if Richard thought of the same thing. May we see it, please?
That's a double-worded answer, and I was just thinking of the...
One word.
Well...
No, two.
Two Empire. Words! Just for you. Hello. Now let's all welcome Diane Kelber. Now, Diane, before we ask you where you're from and all that, we'd like to focus on Charles Nelson Reilly there for a moment. And just find out, what are you doing, Charles?
Well, I didn't know it was noticeable.
What?
I'm just reading a very moving letter from a five-year-old child to the editor in the paper.
What's it saying?
It says, "Dear editor, why has my mommy and daddy and all of America forgotten the Battle of Gettysburg?"
Very moving letter. Okay, thanks, Charles.
I never got a bicentennial minute. This was it.
I didn't either. Okay, Diane, please tell us where you're from.
I'm from Upland, California.
Yep.
And I work for a local government firm where I'm an analyst.
Yep.
And I'm married and I have one child.
Well, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Are you ready to play?
I sure am.
Good, here we go. Boing. A or B, Diane?
B, please.
B it is for Diane. B for Diane, right? Chief Prancing Deer is a very strange Indian. I'm going to tell you how strange he is. Just shut up and be patient. Before he scalps you, he blanks your hair. Chief Prancing Deer is a very strange Indian. Before he scalps you, he blanks your hair. Booth and blank.
Tinkle.
Really?
She has been watching this show. This
democracy gets no respect.
I turned it on last week and I learned the key words. Boobs, tinkle, and here was my opportunity and I blew it. I said
really?
That he went into the... took a nap.
Took a little nap.
Took a nap. Just a moment. One more, please.
Yes, one
May
more.
I just say that I liked the audience yesterday much better than this
one. Yes, of course. They were kinder to you, weren't they? Now, here we go, Brett.
I say, if you gotta go, you gotta go. Tinkle.
Tinkle it is. Tie score. One more wet ballot wins the game for her.
I said, made a dirty phone call. I didn't like the image of Tinkle.
All right. Tie score, 1-1. To be honest with you, I didn't like either candidate who was running for office, so all I did was go into the voting booth and...
Change my clothes!
Very interesting. Came out a Republican. What do you say?
I never thought of ringing a bell at all, darling. That was absolutely marvelous. But I did think of Tinkle.
She's got another shot at Richard. Listen, this is a very close game because her answer was cuss, so the final score really was 2-1. She got 2 there, you got 1. You're a very good game player, and we're delighted to meet you.
I enjoyed it. Thank you.
A lot of gifts will be coming.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye. There it is. Johnny Beetleman. Shall we go?